All right, Michael. So all I've written up here for you is our maxima a posteriori equation, right? So the best hypothesis is the one that maximizes this expression. Nothing new, right? So I want to do a little trick, the same trick that you did before. So you noticed that when we had e to the something, that we could use the natural log on e to get rid of everything. So I'm going to try to do the same thing here. And then why did the natural log work again?
Well, it's the inverse of the e, but it also let us turn products into sums.
Right. And the other reason it worked is because it's a...
Oh, it's monotonic.
Right. It's a monotonic function, and so it doesn't change the argmax. So I'm going to do the log of both sides here, but this time I'm going to do log base 2 for no particular reason other than it'll turn out to help later. So I'm just going to take the log of this entire expression, which, because it turns products into sums, gives me this. And by the way, for those of you who haven't noticed, I threw in a little bit of notation here. When you write just LG, it's just log base 2. Okay, so we agree that the answer to this equation and the answer to this equation is the same. And now I'm going to do one other little trick, exactly the trick that you used before. I'm going to change my max into a min by simply multiplying everything by minus 1.
Okay, don't quite see where you're going here.
But you agree that we haven't changed the answer.
I agree that we haven't changed the answer.
Okay, do a log in there. Do a minus sign in there that took us from a max to a min, but I haven't changed the answer. Now, do you recognize anything about these expressions? I'll give you a hint. Information theory.
Okay, so information theory is usually entropy, which is like sum of P log P stuff.
Right.
I'm not seeing that.
Well, there's your log and there's your P.
Sure. It's not P times that, though.
That's true. But we know from information theory, based exactly on this notion of entropy, that the optimal code for some event with probability p has length minus log base 2 of p. So that just comes straight out of information theory. That's where all the entropy stuff comes from. Okay. So if we have some event that has some particular probability p of happening, the best code for it has this structure, minus log of p.
Okay.
So if we take this fact that we know and we apply it to here, what is this actually saying? This is saying that in order to find the maximum a posteriori hypothesis, we want to somehow minimize two terms that can be described as lengths.
Okay, I see that.
So my question to you is, given that this definition over here, that an event with probability p has some length minus log p, what is this the length of?
So that would be the length of the probability of the data given the hypothesis, and the length of the hypothesis, or the probability of the hypothesis.
Well, no, it's just the length of the hypothesis.
Oh, because the event is what has the length. Oh,
right.
I see. So it's the length of the data given the hypothesis and the length of the hypothesis.
Right. So let's write that out.
But I was just doing like pattern matching there. It's not clear to me what a length of a hypothesis is. Hypotheses are functions. I don't know how to take a tape measure to a function.
That's fair. So this is the length of the hypothesis, right?
Yep.
So you said you don't know what that means, but let's think about that out loud for a moment. What does it mean to have a length of a hypothesis? That's really sort of the number of bits you need to describe a particular hypothesis, right?
Okay.
Okay. Well, in fact, that's exactly what it means. That's why we use log base 2. So if we want to minimize the length of a hypothesis, what does that mean? The number of bits that we need to represent the hypothesis.
The number of bits that we need to represent the hypothesis is, I guess, in some representation, or actually, in this case, I guess it would be some optimal representation. We are taking all the different hypotheses and writing them out. The ones that are more likely have a higher P of H, because that's the prior, and those are going to have smaller lengths in the optimal code, and the ones that are less common are going to have longer codes.
Well, let's make it more concrete.